Hello learner, this is Teacher Nolly from Tayug National High School. Welcome to another session of Programming 1.
This video will help you use loops in Small Basic. You will also realize the importance of subroutine in this video. We have already used sequential and selection control structures in our previous lesson. Let's now have the repetition structure. Repetition structure or loops are used when a program needs to repeatedly process one or more instructions until some condition is met, at which the loop ends. There are two common types of repetition structure. The first one is for loop, and the second one is while loop. In while loop, the number of repetition is already known, and the loop stops in a definite time. But in while loop, the number of repetition is still uncertain, and the loop stops when the condition is false. Below is an example of for loop. As you can see, the program is started with the keyword for. This indicates the start of a for loop. This is followed by the values of the variable a on each loop. As you can see, there will be three values of a, which is 1, 2, and 3. This means that the loop will be repeated 3 times. The next line of code describes what will happen on each loop, which in this case is to write or display the value of a on each loop. And the end for keyword is used to end the for loop. We can see in the output of the program that the value of a is printed 3 times. After number 3 is printed, the loop ends because A has only 3 values and nothing will be displayed after number 3. Here is an example of a while loop. The code is started by setting the initial value of A, which is equal to 10. This is followed by the keyword while, which indicates the start of the while loop, followed by a condition to determine if the looping process will still continue or not. This line of code is basically saying that while the value of a is less than or equal to 30, the loop will continue. The next two lines of code describes what will happen on each loop. The first event is to display the current value of A on each loop. After the value is printed, 10 will be added to the value and the loop will repeat once again, as long as the condition is true. If the condition is false, or if the value of A is already greater than 30, then the loop will stop. The end while keyword will also be used to end the while loop. As you can see in the output, the loop ends when 30 is printed. This value is printed during the third loop. However, nothing is displayed on the fourth loop because the value of A at the start of that loop is already 40. Which is greater than 30. This violates our condition. Thus, the loop ends and the final number that is printed is 30. The importance of subroutine. We all have our daily routines. After waking up, some open their social accounts, some meditate for an hour, and some do their daily exercise. Routines are part of life. Very often, while writing programs, we'll run into cases where we'll need to have to execute the same set of steps over and over again. In those cases, it probably wouldn't make sense to rewrite the same statements multiple times. That's when subroutines come in handy. What is a subroutine? A subroutine is a portion of code within a larger program that usually does something very specific, and that can be called from anywhere in the program. Subroutines are identified by a name that follows the sub keyword and is terminated by the end sub keyword. The importance of subroutine can be highlighted by calling it multiple times in a code. As we can see in our sample program, a subroutine called printTime is made. This subroutine displays the current time. But looking at the output of the program, time is displayed two times. Well, in fact, we only made one subroutine that displays time. This is because this subroutine is called two times on the main program. See, instead of typing the three lines of code to print the time on each part of the program, the subroutine print time is just called, making it easier for a programmer to print the current time multiple times along the program. In this video, you have used loops and learned the importance of subroutines in small basic.
And that ends our lesson for today. See you on our next video. Keep safe.